Thumbelina, Thumbelina, tiny little thing. Thumbelina, dance, Thumbelina, sing. Oh, Thumbelina, what's the difference if you're very small? When your heart is full of love, you're 9 feet tall. Hey!
There was once a tiny little girl. She was no taller than your thumb. So Thumbelina was her given name. A nicely varnished walnut shell made a bed for her with a violet petal mattress and a rose leaf coverlet. In the daytime, she played about in a small dish garden where she rowed her tulip petal boat from side to side of a tiny flower wreath lake. And she sang as she went in the sweetest little voice you ever heard. One night, a great ugly toad came hopping in through the open window and jumped straight to the table where Thumbelina was lying asleep. She would make just the wife of my son, thought the toad. So she snatched up Thumbelina and hopped off back to the garden. There in the muddy bank of a wide brook, the toad made her home with her son. Now, while she decorated a room in their house for her daughter-in-law, the mother toad left Thumbelina on a water lily leaf floating on the brook. And in the morning, when the poor little thing woke up and saw where she was, she cried most bitterly. She could not possibly escape. The little fishes swimming in the water below all swarmed around the tough green stalk that held Thumbelina's leaf, and they gnawed it through with their teeth. And then the leaf carried Thumbelina far down the brook. At last, her leaf boat stopped against a mossy bank in a strange forest world. From blades of grass, she wove a bed. For food, she had honey from the flowers. For drink, the morning dew on the leaves. And so she passed the summer and autumn. Then came winter. All the birds flew away. The flowers withered. The great leaf under which she had lived shriveled to a faded yellow stalk. As Thumbelina searched for her new shelter, it began to snow. She came at last to a field mouse's door. Down below the stubble of a large cornfield, the field mouse had a fine snug house. Poor little thing, said the kindly field mouse, when she found Thumbelina shivering at her door. The mouse took a liking to Thumbelina at once and invited her to stay for the winter. Just so you keep my rooms tidy and nice and tell me stories, she said. Thumbelina agreed and was comfortable there. In the evenings, the field mouse's neighbor often came to call. He was a tiresome old mole. But his house is even snugger than mine, the mouse said. If only you could get him for a husband, you'd be well off indeed. Thumbelina had no intention of marrying the mole. He couldn't bear sunshine and flowers, though he had never seen them. Now, he had dug a long passage from his house to theirs, and there Thumbelina found a bird one day, a swallow, numb and cold. She wove a fine big blanket of hay. She brought him water in the petal of a flower and took care of him all winter long. The tiresome mole proposed to her, and the mouse decided they should be married soon. Poor Thumbelina. She grew sadder and sadder as the wedding day drew near. And when spring arrived and the sun began to warm the earth, Thumbelina opened a hole in the roof of the passage and the swallow stepped out into the sunshine. She watched him with tears in her eyes. Come with me, Thumbelina, she begged. For he could not bear for her to marry the mole and live forever underground. Yes, said Thumbelina, I will come with you. She climbed on the bird's back and tied her sash firmly to his feathers. Then the swallow flew high up into the air over lakes and forests, until at last they came to an ancient palace of shining marble. and here the swallow flew down with Thumbelina. He placed her on a broad flower petal, and there in the middle of the flower was a little man, no bigger than herself. He was the king of the spirits of the flowers. My, how handsome he is, Thumbelina thought, and the little king was equally enchanted at the sight of her. He took the crown from his own head and placed it on hers. Then he asked her if she would be his wife. She said yes to the king. Then, from every flower round about, a tiny lady or gentleman appeared. Each of them brought a gift for the new queen, but her favorite of all was a pair of beautiful wings from a white butterfly, so that she could flit with the others from flower to flower. Such rejoicing as there was then, oh, and the swallow sang for their happiness with all his loving heart.